How you doing? Next up, number 10 in my CPC Spotlight series, is easily one of my favourite games in the Amstrad. And of course, it's a shoot 'em up, Crossout. Crossout is simply awesome. You can see all the awards it's won down the sides there. Some Amiga screenshots on the back. Speaking of which, there's the Amiga box next to the Amstrad box. Some bigger screens on the back there for you. Right, Crossout then. 8 levels of horizontal scrolling shoot 'em up set underwater, which is different. What can we say about it? The Amstrad version is really good. It doesn't compare obviously to the Amiga or even maybe the Commodore 64 version. They have intros, backgrounds and music. The Amstrad one doesn't. But other than that, it's a pretty damn good shoot 'em up. So what makes this different from other shooters, apart from it being really good? You start in a shop. Firstly, you've got a set amount of credits. You can buy a ship and equip it. You only have a set amount of credits, but you can build up your credits on each level. The more you shoot, the more credits you earn. Now, there is actually I wouldn't call it a bug as such in the Amstrad version. You can actually grab hold of a weapon. Instead of putting it on your ship, you can put it in the garbage disposal, which is this little fat creature in the corner, which looks like Jabba the Hutt a bit. Put it in there and your credit goes up, so you can actually end up building up a few ships. You're only supposed to have one ship, but you can have three or four ships and get really further into the game. So it's a nice little bonus, if you like, with the game, and it helps me show you a few more levels later in the video. So there's 4 different types of ship you can have, which are more powerful in turn and more expensive as well. And so there's about 24 different weapons. Look at the back of the Amiga version. There's over 40 aliens. There's also mid-level guardians and end-of-level guardians, the end-of-level guardians are very impressive, especially the first one, which on the Amiga and Amstrad is that one. He's pretty impressive, and you'll see him soon. It's a really playable shooter. Unfortunately, with the tape, as you can see there, it's a multi-load game. I'll show you quickly inside the box. Nice little packaging. So it's only set another set in the future, about another 10 years from now or such, so we haven't got long. It's nothing too much in the manual, to be honest. Just a great game. I hope you all agree. Enjoy the rest of the video.